you get in here? I changed the locks.
I had to see you. I have something to tell you.
Well, tell somebody else. You don't live here anymore, Roger. You're trespassing.
Diane,
no,
please.
Listen to me. You go. I went to New York to get away from you. But could I? No. One of my credit cards was rejected, Roger. The stupid clerk sliced it in half in front of a whole store full of people. I was mortified. You were supposed to pay those bills. You know, I'm telling my father. I'm telling my father how irresponsible that you've been with my money.
Would you please forget about money for a minute?
Why? So you can take more of it away from me?
Something has happened, honey. Something has happened to somebody very close to you.
What? Don't tell me Marcus left town. What did you do to him this time, Roger?
It's not Marcus.
What? Get your hands off of me. What is this
I'm
about?
I'm just trying to ease the blow. It's your grandfather, honey. He's dead.
Josh took that at one of his birthdays.
It's okay to cry.
I don't want to cry. I want to celebrate my father's life. I'm gonna try and find the funeral director.
Yes, please don't do this.
Thank you for making the arrangements. Tasteful and dignified. Father would approve.
How can you do this? How can you insult Daddy's memory and cause our family such pain by bringing your mistress here?
You're not the only one that lost a father, Vanessa. Jessica's here to comfort me. I need comfort, too.
I didn't mean to make a mess.
It's all right, sweetie. You should see the messes I make. Here, let me help.
That's okay. I can do that.
This is a very pretty book. Where'd you get? To Annie. Love, Mommy. All these things are Annie's.
All those things that disappeared that I thought I lost or misplaced. It wasn't me. It was Mara. You know, I asked her once if she saw my clover leaf pin, and she said no. And now I know why she got so upset, because she thought I was accusing her of stealing. I even told her that good little girls don't do things like that.
She wasn't stealing. She was trying to hold on to you. She could see it coming.
See what?
That I was gonna make you go away.
Annie gave them to me.
Oh, I'm sure she did. Here, well, take really good care of those. They're real and they look very expensive.
Annie didn't care. She gave these to me, too.
I didn't say she didn't.
I'll go, put them away. Where do you want me to stay?
Can you stay awake for a few more moments so that we can talk?
I guess.
First of all, I want you to know how thankful I am that you're okay. You can't imagine how many prayers I said for you, and there were a lot of other people that did too. There were so many people looking for you.
I'm sorry.
Honey, I'm not scolding you. And nobody else will either, not your daddy, not Annie. They're gonna be as happy about you being okay as I am. But we do have to call them soon.
Not yet.
Okay. Maybe you can help me understand some other things. Like why you have all of these things that belong to Annie with you. Honey. Please tell me.
They're all I have left.
You did not send me away.
I made the court send you away.
Reva did it. Josh, I know you don't want to hear this, but I know it. You know it, and Mara knows it. Would you listen to me? We cannot give Mara mixed signals on this. It is too big. She has to know the truth. She has to know that we are going to be together no matter where I am living. She has to know how much we love each other and how much we love her.
Hello.
Joshua, it's me. Mara's here.
Thank God!
What? Josh, what? Is it Mara? Did they find her?
She's been here all along at my place.
Josh, please!
She's
what?
Okay. She's all right. Mara's okay. I don't understand, though. How did she end up... How did she end up there?
Well, I'm not quite sure. Apparently, she arrived last night, but I was at the diner. I mean, this is the last place I would have thought to look for her.
Okay, all right. I'm on my way.
What? Wait, Joshua, wait.
What? Who are you talking to?
Reva. Mara's with Reva. So for some reason, she spent the night at...
Joshua. Thank you. Could you just listen to me, please?
Can I talk to her?
Please, let me talk to her.
I don't think that's a really good idea. Not right now, anyway. You can see her when you get here.
All right, fine. We'll be there in just a few minutes. I'm out the door, right?
Please, I know that this is a lot to ask, but I know it's the right thing. Could you, just give me an hour alone with Mara?
Josh, what is she saying? What is she saying?
Just a second. Why?
If you believe that I love our children, you'll do this for me,
Josh, please.
Josh, don't let her play games with you!
Just give me a second, all right, please?
It's just an hour, Joshua. That's all I want.
Okay. All right, you got it. Just hug her for me.
Fine.
Tell her I love her and just hug her real hard for me, okay? Please.
I will. And could you call the diner and let Buzz Cooper and everyone else know that the people that we're looking for, that she's all right?
Sure. Fine, I can do that.
And one other thing. Is Annie missing any personal belongings, some photographs, some jewelry?
Yes. Yes, she is. We assume that Mara took them with her.
Well, you're right, she did.
Did she say why?
No, but I've got a pretty good idea why. Thanks for the time, Joshua, and I'll see you soon.
Annie.
Come on.
Wait, Annie.
Wait for Mom. We have to go get her.
No, we can't. We can't go yet.
I told
Reva that she could have an hour alone.
Well, I don't care what Reva wants. I know what Mara needs, and I'm going.
No, Annie.
I really resent this, Quentin. I really resent your bringing your mistress to Daddy's wake.
You met a much younger man, brought him into the family fold. Why is Jessica so different than Matt?
Well, for starters, I was divorced.
It's the same thing. How long was the ink dry in the divorce papers before you and Matt Reardon took it up?
You don't talk to my wife like that. I don't give a damn if she is your sister. There is no excuse. And there is no excuse for what you're doing to my Aunt Noah either. So don't come in here and try to make everything okay by comparing yourself to me and Vanessa. Is that clear?
You have a pretty big chip on your shoulders, don't you?
Only when someone puts it there.
I'm sorry, Vanessa. I apologize.
everybody's really, really hurting, and just don't let him get to you, okay?
Okay, I won't. Thanks.
Vanessa. Ooh.
Excuse me.
Well, he's some real prize, isn't he?
You know what? I'm just gonna go right up to him, and I'm gonna ask him to take his girlfriend and get the hell out of here.
You know, I just think that... I think we're here to honor Henry, and I... You know, I really don't think he'd want the two of you fighting. So where's Dinah?
Well, she doesn't know yet. I haven't been able to reach her to tell her.
Oh, they were so close.
I know. Oh, Daddy. Daddy could give her the love that she needs. I don't know. You know, Ross and I tried, but...
Well, so, when's she gonna be back?
Oh, she just has a few things that she has to take care of, personal things, and, I hope I can be the one to tell her.
Yeah. She'll probably need you now more than ever. I'm sure you'll come through for her. Yeah, it's a funny thing about parents and children. Hopefully we get lots of chances.
Thanks.
I know what a shock this is, and that's why I came here. I wanted to be the one to tell you.
Why are you lying to me? I know you're lying to me. Honey. I know that my grandfather is alive.
He's dead. He died in his sleep, honey. Quietly, peacefully. They flew him home this morning, and the calling hours are at the funeral home all day, and the funeral's tomorrow. It's in the paper. I know how much you love them. Oh.
Try again. Abby, I told you before that Annie and I are finished, right? But I'm not ready to get involved with someone right now. Do you understand? Man and woman grow apart. Yeah, you're right. Love can end. Like Annie and I. I gotta stop here. Abby, I have to be honest with you. I told you that I like you. You know, and I even love you the same way that you told me that you love the sun and the stars and nature and flowers. But the love between man and woman, the romantic love,
I told your daddy to wait before he rushed over here so that we could have a talk.
He doesn't have to come. He can visit us later, or tomorrow, or next week.
Well, I think he misses you. I'm sure you miss him, too.
I'll be okay without them. It'll just be you and me.
Can't tell you how long I've wanted to hear you say those words. But now that I hear you say them, I'm not really sure that I believe them.
I wouldn't say them if I didn't.
You know, you have to admit that it's been a very long time since we've lived together. We hardly know each other.
We can get to know each other.
That might be hard, though, especially since we haven't had such a great start.
I'm not mad at you anymore.
No? Not even when I kept all those secrets from you?
That's okay.
Like at the carousel? When I looked you right in the eye and I let you believe that I was an angel and didn't tell you that it was really me and that I was really alive?
Let's forget about that.
I'm sure I made you very mad at me, and you know, that's okay. But now, you can tell me anything and I won't get mad. That might be a good thing for you, you know, to just tell me why you came here and decided you wanted to stay with me. Tell me why you brought all those things that belonged to Annie and why you didn't bring your own things, like your clothes or your dolls or even your toothbrush.
I was in a hurry.
Well, I think you had a very good reason for why you did it. Sometimes people do things for reasons and they don't even know about it. I think you had a very good reason why you brought those things with you and why you decided you wanted to stay with me. Do you remember our pinky shake that we had when you were a very little girl?
Not really. Was it like a deal we made together or
exactly.
something?
Exactly. You taught it to me. We used to call it our secret shake or our private pledge. I remember it, do you? Now, we used to hook our little fingers. Just like that. And we'd promise to tell each other the truth. I'll start, okay? Needles.
I don't remember.
Oh, come on, just try. Needles.
Pins.
Exactly. I knew you'd remember. Triplets.
Twins.
When a man marries.
Trouble begins.
When a man dies.
Trouble ends.
What goes up the chimney?
Smoke.
What goes down the chimney?
Santa Claus.
Yeah. Now that pledge will never be broke.
Shakespeare.
Now that oath will never be broken. Now it's only the truth. You don't really want to stay here with me, do you? You want to go and be with your daddy and Annie, right?
Annie, I told Reva that she could spend an hour with Mara, that's all.
What for?
She didn't say why. She just...
Well, then you just gave it to her.
She's thinking about Mara, that's all.
When, sweetie? Since when did Reva Shane ever think about anyone else but herself? Did you forget what she did to us in that courtroom? And you just go along with this?
Annie, I owe her this much.
In heaven's name, why?
Because of Cross Creek. It's only for an hour.
You know, I am trying to wrap my feeble little brain around this one. Ever since Reva has come to town, your daughter has been upset and confused to the point where she ran away from home. And yet you leave her with this woman, this woman who could walk away from
Annie,
her at any given moment.
If Reva wanted to steal Mara away from me, she wouldn't have called in the first place. I'm not going to continue to paint Reva as the bad guy in this situation.
What about Mara? She needs us. I think she needs me. That's why she took my things, because she was so upset that I was ripped out of this place and ripped out of her life.
I know that.
Okay. So she needs to feel safe right now. She needs to feel that we are going to be a family again. Mara, Shane, you and me. She needs to know how much we love each other and that we are going to be together, and no one or nothing is going to get in the way of that. We are, aren't we?
know how it hurts when you lose someone that you love so much. You feel like your life is gonna stop, and you hurt so much that you wish it would. But it won't. You go on. You pull yourself up and you take stock of the things and the people that really matter to you. And you come on. And that's what you're gonna do, honey. And that's what Henry would have wanted you to do.
Don't you pretend like you give a damn about me or my grandfather, because I know you hated him.
That's not true.
And if I would have listened to him, I never would have married you. I should have listened to
him. Please don't say anything you're going to regret. What are you doing?
I'm going to the funeral home.
I'm
going to
take you.
No.
Shape to drive.
No, I can't.
Okay. That does it. I'm driving you, all right? Now, come on. Here. Put your coat on, because it's very, very cold outside.
By to pay my respect. Is there anything I can do?
No.
I know what you and your family must be going through.
I will give your condolences to the family.
Mr. Chamberlain was my son's grandfather. Now I'd like to be able to help somehow.
I suppose you want to see Dinah. She's not here.
Does she know yet?
No, I haven't been able to find her.
Oh, boy. She's crazy about her grandfather. This is definitely gonna hit her hard. I'll go find her.
No, you won't.
Well, then, let me do something about Peter, then.
What do you mean? Why are you bringing up Peter here?
You just lost your father. I don't want you to worry about losing your son.
My son?
That's right. Your son. For the longest time now, my father's been trying to scare you into thinking that you're gonna lose Peter.
Well, that's why you came to town.
That's why my father wanted me back, but that's not why I came back. Now I'm here to tell you that that's never gonna happen. Not now, not ever.
You mean you're not gonna seek for custody of Peter?
Every time I see you and Bridget with Peter, I think of how lucky he is to have you two. And I mean, the thing that you guys have going, it works, and Peter thrives on it. I couldn't ask for more for my child, and I'm not gonna mess with it.
Do you mean that?
I'll sign a piece of paper if you want me to.
Does Bridget know this?
Well, I told her a while back that I wanted to be part of Peter's life, but telling her anything right now is gonna be hard because she won't talk to me.
Well, you better tell her. Tell her. This is important.
I want to get to know Peter again. I want to be part of his life, but not at Bridget's expense and not at yours either. I'm very grateful to both of you.
You know, Ross and I were talking about Henry the other day about all the things that he had taught us. You know, when Rick was a teenager, he helped him get his Eagle Scout badge.
Really, really?
Yeah. Helped him tying knots, helped me appreciate Shakespeare.
Well, he was into so many...
You all right?
I remember Henry said there was always a fine line between someone who was nice and someone who was kind. And he was really kind.
I can't imagine what life would be like without him.
Me neither.
If you're sure you're okay, I'm going outside for a well-deserved dose of nicotine.
It's getting to you too, huh?
Well, yes, I don't really care for funeral parlors.
Yeah. Well, I was talking more about this lousy performance that you're giving.
I know you're angry, and I don't blame you. I didn't say that right.
You're smart and you're beautiful, and I feel very flattered that you feel that way. I know how you feel. I know, Abby, I know.
No! No! I don't love you!
I heard you. Abby, it was wonderful. You're wrong, Abby. Your voice is not ugly. Your voice is a little rusty, that's all. Don't feel funny, don't. You spoke before you lost your hearing, right? Okay, all right. A little practice. Voice will be fine. Just think, Abby. You can tell other hearing people what you think. Your voice is what?
Okay. Not funny.
I know this is hard for you, sweetheart, and it's very confusing, but please, Mara, talk to me.
I want the fighting to stop, Mama.
The fighting between me and your daddy.
I hate it. I don't want it to happen anymore.
But it's not your fault, sweetheart.
I can make it stop.
No. No. You're not responsible for fixing this. Sometimes things happen that can't be fixed. It's like when I went away from you, I didn't want to go away. And when I came back, I never meant to make anyone sad, but it just happened anyway. All I wanted was to be with you and Shane again, and I wanted things to be like they were before.
I remember some things, Mama.
I know. Like a pinky shake.
I don't remember it like you do. It was too far away. You were my angel. Annie was my mommy.
Baby.
That's okay. If I stay with you, then Annie can go back and live with Daddy and Shane. And they'll be a family. Then you'll have me and you won't have to fight anymore.
So that's what this is.
You look sad. Why are you sad if I'm gonna stay with you? Isn't that what you want?
What I want is this. I don't want the fighting anymore either. Everything's gonna be okay, sweet pea. I don't know how, but I promise you that I'll see to it that it is. Pinky promise.
Reva's not gonna do anything to hurt Mara.
How can you say that?
I can say it because it's true.
Did something else happen at Cross Creek? Something that you're not telling me?
Her Reva said that, she admitted that she wasn't handling this situation very well, that she was pushing too hard.
She said this at Cross Creek.
And that she would back off. She would do whatever the psychologist said was best for the children.
Is that all that happened? Was she finally honest about you? Did she finally say that this trial, the lawyers, the threats were about you just as much as they were about the children? Did she finally admit that?
Yes, she did.
Tell her that there was no way that the two of you could get together again. Did you tell her that you loved me?
Yes, I told her that I loved you.
Thank God, I knew you would, sweetie. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to rehash all this. You don't have to go into it. Annie. The most important thing is that you love me and that Mara is safe.
Annie,
Look at me. I don't want her to see me like this, okay? I'm sorry. I'm sorry to drill you on this, okay? I love you, Josh Lewis. And I trust you. Lilies of the valley deck my garden walk. Oh, don't you wish that you could hear them ring? That will only happen when the fairies sing.
And then I took off, scouting the world, too busy to come back and check in. But that doesn't mean that I didn't think about you. I thought a lot about the times that we had, times in between. New, fresh. Springfield was awfully small then. But it was full of hope. I was full of hope. I'm so sorry I let you down, Dad.
I wish to God you were still here. I want to apologize.
I want a divorce.
Can I hear that beautiful voice again? Please, please. Okay, fine, fine. I'm not gonna pressure you. Please. Are we cool? All right, I'm gonna leave to the hospital. Are you sure you're okay?
I'm glad you're here. She's sleeping.
Maura.
Maura!